Hello guys, my name is Mukanya. I'm a CEO and founder at JT Devs. For today's video, we're going to focus on OOP, which stands for Object-Oriented Programming. It does allow us to create reusable code. Features of OOP are object, inheritance, clause, abstraction, polymorphism, and encapsulation. So other features of OOP, we're going to cover that on advanced platform. But for this video, we're only going to focus on class, object, properties, constructors, okay. And then also I'm going to add as a bonus a string method, a str method. I will explain you later on. So let's create a class example in 2022. So the name of this class will be person, and then this person will have a constructor. So this is going to be a constructor. So what is a class? A class is a plane of a thing, as is the same thing that we mentioned on JavaScript. When we were talking about JavaScript tutorials, right? So we mentioned about object-oriented programming also as well in JavaScript. This is how we can create a constructor in Python. So we need for all the features like method, property, and constructor, we need to pass the first argument that we need to pass. It must be a self. So self is similar to this in JavaScript, whereby it actually represents an object of that particular class. There is a self.name equals here. Then those one would be the attributes or class attributes. All right. So we're done with our constructor. Let's create our method. This method, we're just going to allow us to display the details of a person. Just going to use a print statement. Self.name. Then we need a new line. Then that's it. Then let's create an object. We need an object name. Then we don't in Python, when you're creating an object, there's no need to make use of new keyword. So we specify our class name, then that's it. There was a person one dot display. And then when you call a method, there's no need for us to pass self. So we're only going to pass like the value to those arguments if that particular method has some input that we need to provide. But you don't need to specify self when you call a method. All right, so bear in mind. So we're just going to run our file. We say Python, so the file name is oop.py. So here's our results. So let's try to create the second person details, or the details for the second person, the next person. So that would be, so let's just put a line. There is a person 2 equals to person. There we have 2. Okay. So to do that, because if we call again display, it's still going to display our Lerato informations. So we need to provide some properties so that we can actually, okay. Before we have the property, let's first see if we can be able to display the name of the author. Okay, person painter, person one dot name. So let's run it again. So this is not acceptable. So we cannot allow someone else to access the attribute of a class, so like a name or attribute, to be accessed outside of a class. So this is public. We need to make it private. So to make it private, we need to specify underscore. Just after you specify dot, then you put underscore. So this is going to, Python will know that this is going to be private. There we go. So let's create, now we can create a property. So to create a property, let's see, a property just going to be the same thing as we're creating a method, but there's a difference. There's a different approach of how we can create a method and a property. There's a small the small difference between them. So this is going to be just a method. We will say self.underscore name. It's going to return the person name, and then to make it a property, we need to make use of a decorator. So a decorator going to apply, instead of rewrite the code again to make it act as a property, we don't have time to come again to our code and provide the change. All we need to do is to apply a property or a decorator. A decorator is to provide a meaning to that particular, a certain meaning to that particular block. So we specify a property, and then that's it. Just have to remove. Okay, then that's it. This is how we can create a property. And then we need to provide also a set for that, so that we can be able to modify the value of the second person. Then we say this is going to be, okay, let me just, okay, all we need to do is to make a copy of this guy and then paste it in here. Then we need also a decorator that will say name dot setter, and then that's it. And then it will make this method to be a setter, because it's still a property, because we already define it, or we already applied the creator of property to this method, and then now it will act as a property. So let's do this, and then we need to pass a value. We need to say pass name, so that we can pass a new name. We say self dot underscore name equals to name. All right, then I'm going to make a copy of what we have so that we can save time. Then we do the same thing for surname. Alright, copy it. First, we're going to press it right here. Right, press it now again. So now, I didn't lose it. So instead of using those one, now we're going to specify a case so that it's going to be a property. And then when you call a property, there's no need for us to specify the dependency. So that's the difference between a method and the property. So we do the same thing for surname. So, okay, I believe that'll be it. Then I will say person2.name equals to say maybe 10B. Okay, let's say maybe John. Here we have person2.surname. So it will be John. Then after that we say person2.display. Alright. So let's have a look. Let's run it again. No problem. Alright. Gotcha. So we don't need this one anymore. Okay, that'll be it. And here we go. So if so the reason why we needed a setter. Let me just make it short, etc. is because on our constructor, we didn't pass any argument. So this is just a default constructor. And if you want the argument constructor, then you can pass some argument in your some arguments. You can say maybe name, comma, surname. All right. Then when you call or when you're creating an object, then you can pass those person details. Okay, believe that will be it. Let's replace display with underscore str. I will say define underscore str underscore underscore. So you will see the difference between the use of display and the str method. Okay. So this will allow us to return, we need to return. Okay, what I can do, I can just cut this one here. And paste it here. Then it's not easy for me to use again the display. Okay, that is still a method. Then instead of using display, we can just print out the objects. Okay, that'll be object one. Then we'll do the same thing for object two. Say print out person two. All right, let's have a look. Okay, you see, that was fast. Then let's see if we have any other feature that we need to cover before we go. I think that's it. Okay. If you have any questions, please place it on the comments section. Then I'll get back to you. Thank you for watching. Bye. And please remember to subscribe, share, and like the video.